Good evening. Welcome to Fine Print. I'm Molly Gambhir. India today got its first national war memorial 6 decades after the initial demand was made by the country's armed forces. It has been built in remembrance of the soldiers who laid down their lives for the country. Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated that memorial near India Gate this evening. The Indian government in 2015 had approved the project for building the memorial and a national war museum near India Gate in memory of the soldiers who laid down their lives post-independence. The memorial features concentric circles and an obelisk at the center. The granite brick walls of the circles each have the name of a soldier with his ID, rank and regiment. The names of 25,942 martyrs have been inscribed across the 16 walls at the memorial. They are called the honor walls. The Defense Minister, chiefs of the Army, Navy and Air Force were the dignitaries present at the ceremony. The demand for a national war memorial to honor the soldiers killed in independent India had been raised in the past as well by the Defense Ministry. It was in 2006 that a formal proposal was made. The Bharatiya Janata Party first promised a national war memorial during the campaign for the 2014 Lok Sabha elections. The approval for the same came in 2015 when the cabinet gave its nod for the national war memorial to be situated at the C Hexagon east of India Gate. The Prime Minister also addressed ex-servicemen at the National Stadium earlier in the day. He accused his predecessors of ignoring the forces and their demands.
अब देश और आप सभी इस बात के भी साक्षी हैं कि वन रैंक वन पेंशन न सिर्फ लागू हो चुका है बल्कि अब तक 35,000 करोड़ रुपए हमारी सरकार द्वारा वितरित किए जा चुके हैं. सरकार का पेंशन बजट जो पहले 44,000 करोड़ रुपए था अब वो बढ़कर के 1,12,000 करोड़ रुपए से ज्यादा हो चुका है. 2009 से लेकर 2014 तक 5 साल बीत गए लेकिन सेना के लिए बुलेट प्रूफ जैकेट नहीं खरीदी गई. ये हमारी ही सरकार है जिसने बीते 4.5 वर्षों में 2,30,000 से ज्यादा बुलेट प्रूफ जैकेट खरीदे हैं.
Across the world, memorials have been constructed to remind us of the horrors of war and salute the spirit of those who laid down their lives fighting for the nation. A look now at some of the war memorials across the world. The Haifa War Cemetery honors Indian soldiers who liberated Haifa during World War I, considered to be one of the bravely contested battles of World War I. It contains 305 Commonwealth burials of the First World War. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited Haifa in September last year to honor what is considered to be the last great cavalry campaign in history. Haifa Day is celebrated on September 23rd every year to remember the Indian heroes who made that supreme sacrifice. The Soviet World War II Memorial, dedicated to Soviet soldiers killed in the World War II, it is located at the Kremlin Wall in Moscow. It is also known as the Tomb of the Unknown Soldiers. The torch for the memorial's eternal flame was transported from St. Petersburg, where it had been lit from the eternal flame of the Field of Mars. The Arc de Triomphe, one of the most famous monuments in France, honors those who fought in the French Revolution and the Napoleonic Wars. Names of all French victories and generals inscribed on the inner and outer surfaces. Beneath its vault lies the Tomb of the Unknown Soldiers from World War I. The The Vietnam Veterans Memorial, meant to pay tribute to the U.S. soldiers who fought in the Vietnam War. It's known for its black granite wall, which is also known as the wall that heals. Names of more than 58,000 soldiers who either went missing or were killed during the war have been etched on the wall. Memorial for the murdered Jews of Europe, constructed in the memory of 3 million Holocaust victims, made up of 2,711 concrete slabs. The design is such that it produces an uneasy and confusing atmosphere to mirror the plight of the Jews. The monument dedicated to the Battle of Nations, located in Germany, the largest monument in Europe, built to honor those who died in the Battle of Leipzig, 1813. It commemorates Germany's victory over Napoleon. And then there is the monument dedicated to the women of World War II as a British National War Memorial unveiled in 2005. It recognizes the role of women in that world war, 17 items of clothing representing various roles played by women during that war. Shoes on the Danube Bank, which is one of the most moving memorials in Europe. Dozens of iron shoes lined up along the riverbank representing Jews who were forced into the waters during the World War II. In the wake of build-up of forces in Srinagar, the deputy commissioner has assured that the additional troop deployment is in view of elections, which will be announced soon. Take a listen.
First of all, we have advised the public not to go by these rumors, and every information which is being circulated should be first verified. We have our 24/7 lines open. I think many things have been linked unnecessarily without any actual correlation. The security forces are required there because we are expecting announcement of election maybe in 2 weeks from now, and you can't mobilize such huge number of forces overnight. And the forces which the public which is in discussion in public domain are not coming overnight, because 100 companies have to be airlifted or brought by road over a long period of time, and then again they are posted, they are deployed in various districts across Kashmir for conduct of election. This is a routine, regular process. There is no relation to anything else or any speculation which is being circulated.
An urgent notice from the Home Ministry in New Delhi late on Friday evening led to 100 additional companies of paramilitary soldiers being airlifted to Srinagar. The Parliamentary Panel on Information Technology in India has asked the microblogging site Twitter to address the issues of real time and work with India's Election Commission. This, of course, coming in after the panel held a nearly 3.5-hour long meeting with Twitter's Global Vice President of Public Policy, Colin Corbell. Earlier, the Twitter CEO, Jack Dorsey, failed to appear before the panel and instead sent Colin. According to sources, Twitter has been told to engage with India's Election Commission ahead of the upcoming general elections to ensure its outcome is not influenced by foreign entities, quote-unquote. Twitter has now been given 10 days to reply in writing to the questions that remain unanswered during that meeting today. The Twitter officials may be called again before the parliamentary committee. The Indian government has been warning social media platforms of strong action if any attempt was made to influence the country's electoral process through undesirable means. The committee has now summoned senior officials of other social media platforms, including Facebook, WhatsApp and Instagram, for the March 6th.
मुझे प्रसन्नता इस बात की है कि सभी सदस्यों ने बहुत वैलिड क्वेश्चंस पूछे, जिसका आज के समय बहुत महत्व भी है, और ट्विटर ने भी गंभीरता दिखाते हुए अपने ग्लोबल पॉलिसी पब्लिक पॉलिसी हेड को भेजा है, मिस्टर कॉलिन को, और बड़े अच्छे वातावरण में मीटिंग हुई. उन्होंने भी कुछ सवालों का जवाब दिया. जन सवालों का जवाब नहीं दे पाए वो अगले 10 दिनों में लिखित रूप में देंगे, और कमेटी उनको एक बार फिर अगली किसी तारीख पर अपने पास बुलाएगी, और 6 तारीख को फेसबुक, व्हाट्सएप और इंस्टाग्राम के अधिकारी कमेटी के सामने पेश होंगे.